الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا طيبا مباركا فيه نحمده جل وعلا ونستعينه ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونخلع من الحول والقوة إلا إليه نشكره ولا نكفره ونخلع ونترك من يفجره ونشهد شهادة عبد مؤمن أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وتركها على محجة بيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك فصلوات ربي وتسليماته عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين وعنا معهم بعفوك وكرمك ومنك يا أرحم الراحمين أما بعد فيا أيها المؤمنون أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله جل وعلا All praise is due to Allah the Almighty Allah, the Creator. Allah, who created us and created everything in this life for us. So we may live and believe and enjoy and be righteous. I testify before your heart and your mind and your spirit. There is no God but Allah, the Almighty. And I testify that Muhammad, peace be upon him, the seal of all the prophets, who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent in the city of Mecca and revealed unto his heart the divine revelation in the top of the Mount of Light in Mecca. And I testify that our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, conveyed the sacred message, clear from any doubt, to take people from darkness to light from the day he received it until the day of judgment. For that I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the hearts of the believer for the continuous blessing unto him, unto his family, unto his companion, unto his follower, and unto you until the day of judgment. O believer, men and women, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you this character on the day of assembly, the day of Friday, when he called upon you and he said, Ya أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع. So Allah the Almighty granted you this character on the day of Friday and the day of assembly when he called upon you to leave this dunya, to leave this life and come to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To come to inject this life into the heart of the believer where he is thirsty of the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he remember him when he remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the heart and the spirit will be satisfied by what comes their way and I admonish you with purifying the heart by coming to Allah with taqwa And the taqwa is to know who Allah is. When you know who is He, then you submit. Then you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willingly. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who loves us dearly, wants us to live our life by the revelation, by the tanzeel, to live by the tanzeel as the Prophet, peace be upon him, explained to us the Quran clearly. And he left with no doubt in this clarification and explanation to all of us. And as Imam Ali summarized the taqwa, and I repeated this many times over and over, when he said, At-taqwa makhafatul jaleel, wal-amalu bil-tanzeel, wal-rida bil-qaleel, wal-istidadu li-yawm al-raheem. That summarizes who we are, summarizes our faith as Muslims, that we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, And we live our life in this life by the revelation of the Holy Quran, whether in action or in worship or in mission. And we pleased by what comes our way. And we prepare every day that we've been granted freely from God the Almighty, God the most gracious, most merciful. We prepare ourselves to leave this life. None of us will live forever. Let us look behind you. Look at those famous. Look at those celebrities. Look at the kings and the presidents. Look off all of those. Where are they at? They are down. What they took with them, other than the action and the deed that they did and presented to themselves as they were living in this life. So I said this just to bring to your attention one of the greatest fuqaha. When he asked to write the fuqah, and he said, I would like to start my writing by writing the book about az-zuhd. And this greatest faqih is Abu Hanifa al-Nu'man. So he started his book by writing about al-buyu'. And he said, this is the first in Kitab al-Zuhd, al-buyu'. Because when you through al-buyu', you come to this dunya. And you love this dunya. And it comes to you. So if you own it, but you do not love it. You own it, but you do not trust it. It means that az-zuhd is three words to explain. He said to trust what's in the hand of Allah more than what's in your hand. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى أَنْ رَآهُ اسْتَغْنَى إِنَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ الرُّجْعَى. So, the scholars start writing about how to build this. And mistakenly sometimes we believe that az-zuhd, to leave this life, is to tuharrim al-halal, to leave everything and live in the corner. And that's not the meaning of az-zuhd. لا تحرم حلالا ولا تمنع مالا أو ولا تبطل مالا. So the scholars try to explain to us how to deal with this life that we live. And you live, look at us. We go to school, we study, we obtain degrees, we find a job, because all of this for the dunya, to pay the bills. And this life we live in is push, 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 rush, rush, rush. Can you escape it? Well, the scholars usually said in some meditations and some words that they really brought to us, and it is from the text of the Holy Quran. He said, one of them, he said, a question, oh scholar, how might Allah loves me? And how might the people love me? He said clearly to him, when he asked, دُلَّنِي عَلَىٰ عَمَلٍ إِذَا عَمِلْتَهُ أَحَبَّنِ اللَّهِ وَأَحَبَّنِ النَّاسِ. Trying to explain what he understood from the Prophet, peace be upon him, saying in action and really decree, he said, إِزْهَدْ فِي الدُّنْيَا إِزْهَدْ فِي الدُّنْيَا يُحِبُّكَ اللَّهِ وَازْهَدْ فِيمَا أَيْدِ النَّاسِ يُحِبُّكَ النَّاسِ. إِزْهَدْ فِي الدُّنْيَا يُحِبُّكَ اللَّهِ وَازْهَدْ فِيمَا أَيْدِ النَّاسِ يُحِبُّكَ النَّاسِ. So it's clear to all of us that this life that we run after, we worry about our substance, we worry about our jobs, we worry about the economical system. Brothers and sisters, don't worry. Because the manager who managed this life is the merciful. Who managed this life is the giver, the creator, who gave you freely your life and what you have. And they, in the old days, they said, Your risk, your substance will follow and search for you more than you search for it. Why is it? Because الثقة بما عند الله. الثقة بما في يد الله. وفي السماء رزقكم وما توعدون. وفي السماء رزقكم وما توعدون. That's your substance and mind is coming from the heaven, coming by the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إنه لحق مثل ما أنكم تنطقون. It's a truth. As you and I have the ability to speak. So if you worry about this, don't worry. It's going to come to you. But if you get it, be among those. They have the trust in what Allah has for you than what you have in your hand. It means don't worry about this life. Don't worry about, you know, if you want to give, give for the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And don't fear the poverty. Because this is all in the hand of the Creator who created us and gave us, even though He gave your own child. نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُهُمْ وَإِيَّهُمْ. And in the other ayah, نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُهُمْ وَإِيَّكُمْ. So now both ways, it comes to you. So don't worry. Concentrate on being thankful to Allah. Concentrate in being, you know, sabirin, for the calamity comes from Allah, the Almighty. And the three things, as I said, the scholars explained the Zuhd, that you trust what on the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than what's in your hand. And the equation that we sometimes come over. When the calamity hit us, you see us terrified. And some of us question, why is me? Why just me and my family? When I lose a business or lose a child or lose a, you know, father or mother, you see this worry and you're terrified. And Allah is saying, reminding you and I that inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We all belong to Allah. We are going to repent and return to Him. We all returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at one point. So this life, it doesn't equal in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of the wing of mosquitoes. Because if it is, ما سقى الكافر منها شربة ماء لا تساوي عند الله جناح بعوضة. If it is, ما سقى الكافر منها شربة ماء. That this life that we live, in another explanation, what you taken from it? They said, you taken from it as you put your finger in the ocean and you come out. What you come? It's nothing. So believers, men and women, if the calamity hit you, it is from God Almighty as a test and a great reward. It's a reward through testing. And you see, this morning, the people in Turkey woke up on the adhan of Erdogan, the president of the country, made adhan al-Fajr. Adhan al-Fajr. And those, they are, لو يعلمون ما في الفجر, that they know what's in the morning. As the Prophet, peace be upon him, told his daughter Fatima, Ya Fatima, قومي فاشهدي رزق ربك. In the Fajr morning. The people over there heard the adhan and the sweetest voice of Erdogan, who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hit him with calamity few days before that they had the coup and tried to get rid of him. Why? Because the world sensed that he is trying to direct his country toward Islam. Let us wake up. If we keep grabbing on this dunya, we will never gain the honor. If we try to use it and utilize it for spreading the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the honor has to come. And then the ummah will be raised. And from among them, Every 100 years, as the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, that Allah will send someone who has some wisdom to bring it to the attention of the believer. So let us pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those they are the ones they accept to be زاهدين in this life. من أهل الزهد في هذه الدنيا. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us understand who we are, understand the mission that Allah commissioned us to do, understand our book to live by it, and then get protected and rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we learn that to have a trust in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised us, and Allah promised us the heaven. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to all of us, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ. So let us ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah bring the tawbah to our heart, that Allah accept our repentance for His love, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala empowered us to come back to be the people of righteousness, the people that they are. Their mission is to bring people from darkness to light. Oh Allah, we pray and we cry to you. You know where we stand and you know what we have in our heart. Empower us, oh Allah. Empower us to be a sincere, devoted Muslim to you, oh Allah. Believers, listen and adhere to what the Prophet, peace be upon him, said. He said to all of us, التائب من الذنب كمن لا ذنب له. ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. They pray to Allah and repent to Him with sincerity in your heart, that Allah heals and responds to all of us. Alhamdulillah wa kafa. Wa salatu wa salamu ala man istafa. Sayyidina wa habibina wa qaidina Sayyidina Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama ajma'in. Brothers, you may come forward and have a space to your brothers. Believers, to summarize how to be among the winner in this life, to summarize what the hadith said to all of us, that you have a zuhd in this dunya and you obtain the love of Allah, and you have the zuhd in what's in the hand of the people, and the people will love you as well. We have to come back to live seriously and sincerely by the book of Allah and by the saying of our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, who explained all of this to us. And in continuing of the explanation of the zuhd, as the scholar said to all of us, that this zuhd, that to trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than we trust what we have, and to have equal to us what happens in this life. If the calamity hit us, let us be among the sabirin, because as-sabiruna yuwaffawna ujurahum bighayri hisab. Let us be among those they attain sabr. Sabiru wa sabiru. That is what the Prophet, peace be upon him, explained to all of his follower and believer when he fought the disbeliever one day in Mecca and also in Medina. And the believer did follow his steps, and not just only what he said and what he did, but even they walked in Medina and Mecca and stopped at every place that the Prophet, peace be upon him, stopped. Those they are going to go to Hajj by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I advise them to study and educate themselves before they go about all of this. So inshallah, when they go over there, they will follow and be in the places where the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, stayed. And the third, which is the scholar, is saying to us that having someone to praise you or insult you, praise you or insult you in the truth of the matter, it doesn't have to matter to you. It doesn't have. And you do not leave the truth because they are going to insult you. And you do not really do what the truth push you to do because they will stop praising you. So if this is, will become equal in your sight, that you will be considered among those they have the zuhd in their heart from this life. Because all what we care for in our life is a hereafter. And the first and the last mission that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned to us in the Holy Quran, as Allah said, وَابْتَغِ فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ. ولا تنس نصيبك من الدنيا وأحسن كما أحسن الله إليك. So our mission is for the hereafter, and that's why among the taqwa elements is a preparation to leave. So are we prepared? Are we ready to leave? Did we fulfill what the Prophet, peace be upon him, said to all of us? So we have a clarity of the heart. The good hearts is a heart that is going to be enter the heaven. Did we prepare our wasiyah? مَذَا بَلَغَ أَحَدُكُمْ لَا يَنَامَنَّ أَحَدُكُمْ إِذَا بَلَغَ إِلَّا وَوَصِيَّتُهُ تَحْتَ رَأْسِهِ. Do we have our wills to be under the pillow before we sleep? And this is to all of us. Don't let this amal, don't let the hope make you lazy and not to follow what the Prophet, peace be upon him. So believer, I remind myself and remind you that this great jump, the great things that the Prophet, peace be upon him, left for us to be safe in this life and rewarded in the hereafter. So we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those. They are so sincere in following their religion, so sincere in following the steps of our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So they will be among the winners in this life and the hereafter. They will win the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they will win the protection of Allah in this life. Oh Allah, we pray to show your mercy unto us, the mercy unto our fathers and mothers, to show unto us the forgiveness, oh Allah, that we are looking. Oh Allah, forgive our parents and their parents. Oh Allah, forgive our scholars and their scholars. Oh Allah, empower us to be a sincere, devoted believer to you. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وتب علينا وعافنا واعف عنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أنك تعلم ما في قلوبنا. اللهم إنا نسألك يا أرحم الراحمين أن تغفر لنا ذنوبنا. اللهم إنا تبنا إليك وأبنا إليك وعدنا إليك فارحمنا برحمتك التي وسعت كل شيء يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ارحم إخواننا المسلمين في كل مكان وانصرهم على عدوهم يا أرحم الراحمين. فأنت خالق الإنسان وأنت الرحيم وأنت الرحمن. اللهم ارحمنا برحمتك التي وسعت كل شيء. عباد الله، إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم، وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.